Hey Survivor fans, please like, share, and subscribe. Check out my Survivor puzzle app. The link is in the video's description.
39 days, 20 people, 1 survivor. Previously on Survivor. Over the past 10 years, some of Survivor's most memorable castaways played the game with honor and integrity.
In my world, I've always tried to show that good will win.
While others relied on ruthless cunning and backstabbing.
I'm the original villainess of Survivor, and I gotta tell you, I feel like Mother Teresa right now with these people.
In the historic 20th season of Survivor, 10 of the most notorious villains have returned to face 10 of the greatest heroes. Russell has the bag for the villains! The first challenge was a fierce battle. The heroes suffered 2 injuries.
My toes broke.
But ultimately prevailed.
Heroes win reward!
Filled with confidence, the heroes worked well together and built a solid camp.
I love my tribe. We have a good aura. We have good energy.
But not every hero acted heroically. JT dipped into the villain's playbook and formed conflicting alliances.
I'm gonna form alliances with everyone I can.
So it's gonna be a whole different ballgame for me.
At the villain's beach, Boston Rob was the only one who worked, and the camp suffered.
They don't want to build a shelter. They don't want to try to get a fire going. There's nobody here that wants to do anything.
But unbeknownst to Rob, Russell was very busy.
We're going
to
be better of a pair than you can even possibly imagine.
I agree.
Up to his old tricks, making secret deals with Danielle and Parvati.
With Russell, I definitely feel like I am making a deal with the devil. But I want the devil on my side.
And Coach was making gallant advances towards Jerri.
Jerri and I, we had a little connection.
Survivor's ready. Go!
Come on, heroes!
At the immunity challenge, the heroes opened a huge lead.
Heroes look like they've been paddling together forever!
Yeah!
But when they got to the puzzle, things changed.
Heroes still trying to figure out the first piece of this puzzle.
Wait, you know, maybe just 2 different pieces that fit.
Sugar and Amanda were unable to work together, allowing the villains to pull ahead.
Villains win! Yeah! First immunity challenge!
At Tribal Council, the heroes unanimously voted to make Sugar pay for her poor performance at the challenge.
Sugar, the tribe has spoken.
And now both tribes are facing tough questions. Did the heroes make the right choice to strengthen their tribe? As for the villains, with torrential sea storms on the way, will the lack of shelter zap their strength and kill any chance of future victory? Previously on Survivor.
Oh, yeah!
When the 2 tribes first hit the beach, they stayed true to their nature. The heroes were heroic, and the villains were villainous. The heroes overcame injuries.
My toes broke.
To win the first challenge, they also tirelessly worked together to build a great camp.
Watching these guys working together, it's good to be a hero.
Get your evil on.
The villains did not work together and complained about everything.
I feel like instead of taking 2 steps forward, we keep taking 4 steps backward.
It was the perfect environment for Russell to work his black magic. Russell made deals with anyone who would listen and even roped in Parvati.
This is what I want. I don't want anyone to go to the top.
But by day 2, the game started to change. At the Heroes Camp, JT embraced the dark side by making conflicting deals with James and Tom.
But I'm willing to make alliance right now with you. I mean, yeah. I haven't made alliance with nobody.
You're my guy for the end.
All right, you got me.
At the Villains Camp, Boston Rob behaved heroically. He worked hard around camp and even built a fire without Flint.
There we go.
And after getting sick and passing out, he got up and led his tribe to a come-from-behind victory at the Immunity Challenge.
Villains win! Yes! Second Immunity Challenge in a row!
After their 2nd defeat in a row, the heroes were demoralized, and James lashed out.
He was telling you what to do. Everybody mouth want to talk.
At Tribal Council, James continued his tirade.
You're trying to blame this entire challenge on me?
And JT's duplicity was revealed when he chose not to honor his alliance with Tom by voting out Tom's closest ally, Stephenie.
Steph, the tribe has spoken.
18 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor.
Heroes, for the second time in a row, you guys will lose somebody at Tribal Council.
By day six, the heroes had lost two challenges and were beaten and demoralized.
If we don't become a cohesive team, we will continue to lose.
Things were so bad that some of the heroes started to behave like villains. James bullied the tribe.
One voice, that's all I ask. Then I get people telling everybody they're wrong.
And JT was equally villainous.
I'm gonna form alliances with everyone I can. My strategy is to keep everyone on my side, man.
He made conflicting deals with both James and Tom. At the villains camp, Rob's heroic actions made him the de facto tribe leader.
You are the man, and it's like when you're talking, I'm just hanging on every word.
I appreciate it.
Rob thinks he's the boss of the camp,
but this is my mountain, and I'm still the king of the hill.
Russell got fed up with his tribe following Rob and staged a rebellion by hiding the machete.
Getting rid of the machete will cause conflict in this camp, and that's a good thing.
Go! But at the last immunity challenge, everything changed.
Heroes win!
The heroes destroyed the villains in a huge blowout.
In addition to immunity, you have coffee, sugar.
Yes!
At Tribal Council, Sandra called out Coach for being lazy.
Coach will delegate, you do this and I'll do this and we'll go do that. But then when you look, Coach is gone 2 miles out.
But in the end, the entire tribe voted out their oldest and most abrasive member.
Randy, the tribe has spoken.
Now, if the villains can't get their act together, the heroes will even the score. 17 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor. On day 10, when the heroes discovered a clue to the hidden immunity idol,
and the immunity idol is hidden at your camp,
the entire tribe scattered across the beach.
Who's walking down that way?
Each person selfishly looking for the idol alone. Tom was the one to find it.
I have the immunity idol, but I'm still a target because they know it's in my possession.
Conversely, the villains agreed to stick together and ignore the clue entirely.
It's not fair for one person to have an immunity idol.
Except for Russell, who searched for the idol but couldn't find it.
He's a stupid ass.
And instead found himself on the outs with his tribe.
If you go for it, then you're still your own fate.
Exactly. At the immunity challenge, Boston Rob once again led the villains to victory.
Villains, win immunity!
At the heroes camp, JT agreed to vote with Cirie and the majority of the tribe to take out Tom.
I want Tom to go.
But at tribal council, JT betrayed his alliance and voted for Cirie.
Jeff, I have something that I was hoping not to use.
So when Tom played the hidden immunity idol, Cirie was sent home.
Cirie, the tribe has spoken. I would say that qualifies as your first blindside.
16 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on...
JT and Boston Rob go at it hard.
Survivor.
Coach takes a hard hit.
By day 12, it was all-out war between the heroes and the villains.
Whoa! Stop! Stop!
And James was the latest casualty. But the biggest battle was back at the villains' camp. Parvati was fighting for her life.
Move your arms like this.
Parvati is the most dangerous player on our tribe.
Meanwhile, Russell and Rob battled it out for tribal supremacy.
It's personal with me and Rob. He thinks he's tough. May the best man win.
Russell believed he was in an alliance with Danielle and Parvati, and he had the hidden immunity idol. Rob believed he was aligned with everyone else.
There goes.
Rob jumps down on the final piece! Win immunity!
But when Rob led the villains to yet another victory, his battle with Russell was postponed.
Villains, congratulations.
While the heroes were marching into another vote, James's injury made him a liability, and Candice considered voting with the outsiders, Tom and Colby, to take him out.
You can't lug around dead weight, and James is a lot of dead weight.
But at tribal council, she played it safe and voted with the majority to take out Tom.
The tribe has spoken.
Making Colby the odd man out in a tribe going nowhere fast. 15 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor.
Villains win immunity! Yes! Oh my God!
For 3 long weeks, the heroes had been perfecting the art of failure.
Villains have now won 4 out of 5 immunity challenges.
To make matters worse, Colby, a consistent winner in seasons past, was tangled in mediocrity.
He has not done anything. It's like my Superman sucks.
I suck!
Meanwhile, the villains appeared to be invincible.
I feel
like a big man.
Right.
But the announcement of a double tribal council.
Tonight, both tribes are voting somebody out.
expose the villain's Achilles heel, a rift between Russell and Boston Rob.
I don't trust Russell's ass at all. He's like the Hobbit on crack.
It's personal with me and Rob. I don't think he knows who he's dealing with.
Danielle and Parvati were firmly in Russell's camp, with Sandra, Courtney, and Tyson in Rob's. Both sides were vying for the attention of the Dragon Slayer and his fair maiden. But right before Tribal Council, Russell planted a seed in Tyson's head, suggesting he vote out Parvati.
But I'm gonna vote for Parvati, and then that'd be it. Man, I don't like doing it, but got to.
Deal.
All right, man.
Yep, we're tight, deal.
But at the villain's tribal council, Russell pulled a double cross by giving Parvati his hidden immunity idol. She played the idol, Tyson took the bait, and Boston Rob's closest ally went home.
Tyson, chop spoken.
Later, when the heroes took their seats at tribal council, Colby dodged a bullet when the tribe voted out James because he was injured. Now, only five heroes remain against eight villains. Who will be voted out tonight? Last week, 20 seasons of Survivor led up to our most epic battle yet. Rob Mariano, one of the game's ultimate strategists and also one of the biggest double dealers, had recreated himself as a hero.
A lot has happened with me personally in my life in the 6 years since I've played this game. I'm learning compromise and patience.
He led his tribe of villains by being a straight shooter and working hard.
I'm in awe of Rob. You are the man, and it's like when you talk, I'm literally hanging on every word.
I appreciate it.
Because of his efforts, the tribe flourished.
Rob jumps down on the final piece! Villains win immunity!
But he made an enemy of Russell.
Watch your back, man.
Yeah, same thing for you, man.
Who used lies, intimidation, and chaos to further his own self-interest.
I'm that good. Well, I could bring people together in this game for my good.
So Rob's leadership was short-lived.
My idea of trust and loyalty is different from Russell's.
Motivated by jealousy, Russell used his power of persuasion and gathered enough votes to eliminate his adversary.
Rob.
The loss of Rob has given the heroes a chance at a comeback. Now they're down only two members. And they've even discovered a clue to a hidden immunity item.
We're gonna look for it together.
But the bigger question, how will losing Rob's leadership and challenge dominance impact the villain tribe?
The waters are so muddy right now. I mean, we were in the best position possible.
Coach, Courtney, and Sandra refused to vote for Rob, and now they're trapped in a tribe controlled by Russell, whose ego may have just put the villains in a hole they can't get out of. Previously on Survivor. Although there were only five heroes left, they appeared to be a tight-knit group.
Best team in Survivor right here.
But their unity was only an illusion, because when JT found a hidden immunity idol, Amanda and Candice decided he wasn't as trustworthy as they thought.
JT is the slimiest guy out here.
The heroes had also convinced themselves that the villain's tribe was completely controlled by women.
Sure looks like they got a women's alliance.
But there was no women's alliance.
The hero tribe thinks this is an all-girl alliance. They think I'm on the outside when I'm the leader.
In fact, two of the women, Sandra and Courtney, were in the greatest danger.
We're the ones on the outs.
When the villains lost their fourth challenge in a row,
heroes win immunity!
Courtney was the next to go, but Sandra made a brilliant move to save her friend. She convinced Russell the coach had turned on him.
He's not a man of his word. Russell's so stupid, he ate that crab up.
Her plan worked. Courtney was spared, and Coach was voted out.
Coach, Travis Bogan.
Leaving Jerri without her closest ally. 11 are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Previously on Survivor. With their numbers dwindling, each of the villains were making plans for a possible merge.
If we merge, I have control of the villain camp. Complete control.
Russell thought he was pulling all the strings, but Parvati made moves of her own.
Another immunity idol is hidden at your camp.
She tracked down a hidden immunity idol, telling only her friend Danielle.
Right now, Russell doesn't need to know.
While the outcasts, Courtney and Sandra, merely wanted to survive.
It's inevitable that me or Courtney are going home.
The heroes were equally sure a merge was coming, and even more sure that Russell was on the outs with the villains.
That women's alliance looks very strong.
So they came up with a plan to pull in Russell by giving him an idol with instructions to take out Parvati.
This is your chance to show you're not a villain.
At the last immunity challenge,
heroes win immunity!
The heroes celebrated another win as JT gave Russell an idol and a chance to become a hero. But Russell's a villain.
You don't hand the enemy the idol.
In a brilliant double cross, Russell kept both the idol and his ally, Parvati.
Shut up!
As he and his female accomplices laughed all the way to tribal council, where they voted out Courtney.
Courtney, tribe has spoken.
And Sandra was left all alone, angry at her own tribe.
We are now even. Five villains, five heroes.
With both tribes equal in number, the real battle is about to begin. Who will be voted out tonight in Heroes versus Villains? Previously on Survivor. The heroes and villains merged with even numbers. The heroes thought they had the upper hand when Russell promised his allegiance.
This is where I stand. I swear to my kids that I am on board with y'all.
But he was only reeling them in.
Hook, line, and sinker.
Sandra warned the heroes not to trust Russell.
Russell's the kingpin.
But only Rupert believed her.
If Russell is playing us,
he's not.
I just want to make sure. He's on the villain side for a reason.
At the last challenge, Danielle got the immunity necklace around her neck, and the heroes tried to put a noose around Parvati's.
They're trying to vote me out.
Yeah, they want you gone.
Russell gave up his hidden immunity idol to save his queen, but Parvati was only using him as a pawn. Unbeknownst to him, she had a second, secret idol of her own.
Two little green men protecting me.
At a game-changing tribal council, the heroes switched their vote to Jerri. Parvati, sensing something was wrong, made a huge move.
Sandra, that's for you. Jerri, that one's for you too.
Damn it.
She played both her idols to save the villains and send home JT. Leaving Russell wondering who's really in charge.
Somebody explain it to them.
Nine are left. Who will be voted out tonight? In a totally unpredictable season, only one thing was certain.
He's threatening Russell Hantz. When you do that, you go.
Anyone who targeted Russell.
Watch your back, man.
Same thing for you, man.
Found themselves blindsided instead. Tyson, Boston Rob, Coach, Courtney.
Tribe has spoken.
He achieved his goals with lies and deception.
This is where I stand. I swear to my kids that I am on board with y'all.
Hook, line, and sinker.
The only person to cross Russell and still survive.
Yeah, I trust you.
Was Sandra.
But whatever Russell says, he's lying.
Behind his back, she convinced the heroes to join forces with her and take him out.
You want Russell gone?
Yeah.
Russell's gone.
But Candice saw an opportunity to further her own game and joined up with Russell, warning him he was in trouble.
What name they gonna put down? Me?
With her plans betrayed, Sandra was forced to rejoin the villains.
You saying you're gonna vote for me?
No, nobody's gonna vote for you.
At tribal council, a frightened Russell played the hidden immunity idol.
Russell's super paranoid, and that is going to be his downfall.
Russell wasted his idol because both Candice and Sandra voted with the villains.
Amanda, the tribe has spoken.
Leaving the heroes in their toughest position so far. What they don't know is that tonight there will be two immunity challenges, two tribal councils, and two more survivors will meet their fate. Previously on Survivor. In just over 30 days, the alliance of Parvati, Danielle, and Russell built an empire.
They're all falling together perfectly.
They had coerced Jerri and Sandra into voting with them and whittled the heroes down to only two members.
Colby and I are standing out on a sinking ship now. There are no other heroes.
I trust you.
But Sandra had been secretly working against Russell's alliance.
You want Russell gone?
Yeah.
Russell's gone.
And she had just found a hidden immunity idol that she kept secret.
I think I'm gonna keep it for myself because I'm so damn creepy.
When Rupert lost the last immunity challenge, Russell wins immunity! It was clear he was the next to go. But Russell saw Danielle and Parvati growing too close for comfort.
To me, they're a team when it's supposed to be me and Parvati. And that's a problem. The only thing I can think of right now is to break up that couple.
So he targeted his own alliance.
And yeah.
Yeah.
He secured votes from the heroes and tried to get one from Jerri.
You don't get rid of Danielle, you're gonna be after her.
At tribal council, Danielle broke down.
was a freaking wreck. I was so exhausted. It's just too much for me right now.
And let slip how tight her alliance was with Parvati.
I'm closer to the Parvati than you think.
Oh, really?
So Russell gave the signal and brought his empire crashing to the ground.
Danielle, Travis spoke.
Now everyone's left to scramble for new alliances. Six are left. Who will be voted out tonight? Sandra tracked down a hidden immunity idol to protect herself.
I would hate to go home with the idol in my bra.
She played it at the last tribal council, but she wasn't the one who needed protection.
Rupert, the tribe has spoken.
Now only five remain.
Without warning, Colby's plates drop. Parvati wins her second immunity challenge in a row. Parvati, safe tonight at Tribal Council, guaranteed a spot in the final four. 16th person voted out and the 8th member of our jury. Colby, that's three, it's enough. Need to bring me your torch. Colby, Travis spoken. Time to go.
Hits the post!
Oh, man!
Russell wins immunity!
For real?
Russell, safe at tonight's tribal council, which means you will go to final tribal council. You will get a chance to plead your case for $1 million. 17th person voted out, and the 9th and final member of our jury. Jerri, need to bring me your torch. Jerri, drop the spoon.
Okay.
Russell.
You know, everybody thinks that this game is a game of luck. Some cases, I believe it is. In my case, I don't believe it is. I played as hard as I possibly could play, and for some reason, you know, when I come here, I feel that people look at me like I did something wrong. You know, I tried to play hard. That's what I did. If I did anything to offend anybody in this game, I apologize. But I played the game. That's all I can say.
Parvati.
I came into this game knowing I was going to play with 20 of the best survivors ever. What I didn't realize was the threat that I was to everyone in this game. So immediately I had to put a line of defense together, and that's where Russell came in. He was the dragon. And instead of slaying him, I kept him as my pet. You know, I think I played the ultimate social game, the ultimate strategic game, and the ultimate physical game.
Sandra.
I mean, we all know how survival works. I've been soul surviving since my alliance was wiped out. I got to the Heroes camp. I tried to get rid of Russell 3 different times. I'd have to work my way around things at camp, try to make sure to take all the precautionary measures to ensure that when I brought my torch in here lit, that it left here lit. And I did that by myself.
That's 4 votes, Sandra. 3 votes, Parvati. Now there's 2 votes left. The winner of Survivor, Heroes vs. Villains, Sandra.
Thank you.